Yes, good morning students. In the previous session we've discussed about the MOSFET. So power MOSFET and what exactly power MOSFET is, how it is constructed and different characteristics of power MOSFET, that is input characteristics, output characteristics, switching characteristics of power MOSFET, okay, and applications or advantages, disadvantages of MOSFET in the previous class we had discussed. Right, now we'll in this session we'll discuss about the another type of power, transistor, that is bipolar junction transistor. So this bipolar junction transistor is already discussed in your previous semester in analog electronic circuit theory part, but somehow we'll discuss a few points about the bipolar junction transistors and then take some of the problems on the same, and then we'll move further for the other type of the transistors. Okay, so bipolar junction transistor is shortly called as BJT, that is bipolar junction transistor. So this BJT has a three terminals, so those terminals you can name it as a emitter, collector, base. So whereas your MOSFET is having gate, drain and source, whereas BJT is having a three terminal, that is emitter, collector and base. So it has a three layer, that is NPN, N layer, P layer and N layer, or PNP, that is P layer, N layer, PNP transistor and NPN transistor, two types of transistors we have. So we can see the representation of the transistor here. This is a NPN type of the transistor and this is a PNP type of the transistor. Okay, so this is a constructional feature of NPN. This is a constructional feature of constructional view of a PNP transistor, and this is the symbolic representation of NPN and this is the symbolic representation of PNP transistor. Okay, so here it is also consisting of a N layer, P layer. So here there is a layer doping of the different layers. So N layer, P layer and heavily substrated N layer. So NP and here, so heavily doped P layer, then N layer, then P substrate. So they are doped one above the other to form the your transistor here. So this is a base, heavily doped N layer will forms the, so heavily doped N layer will forms the emitter here. Okay, here heavily doped P layer forms the collector here. Okay, so and here N substrate will forms the collector, here P substrate will forms the collector. So this is the base of the transistor. This is the base of the transistor. Okay, now this is symbolic representation of the transistor. It is represented as emitter, base, collector. So symbolic representation is given here. So only the difference between these two is the flow of current. So this is away from the base and this is towards the base. So this is how you can differentiate the transistor as NPN type and PNP type. Okay, see, now the figure shows the constructional details of the PNP transistor and NPN transistor, as I already said, and the symbolic representation of this is also shown here. So two heavily doped N plus semiconductor forms the emitter of the NPN transistors, two P plus layer will collector forms the PNP, that is already explained. So now the steady state characteristics of BJT, as I explained, to understand the behavior of any of the switch, so we have to understand the steady state characteristics, that is the output characteristics and input characteristics of any of the switch here. So here also in the previous video also we discussed about the characteristics of switch, that is MOSFET switch, how it will behave for the variation in the drain current and source current. Okay, so here also in BJT, so we have to, if you want to understand the behavior of BJT, so to choose it for the different applications, we have to study the characteristics of that particular switch. So here this circuit will indicates the equivalent circuit to draw the characteristics of a bipolar junction transistor, and this graph will indicate the input characteristics. So input characteristics of BJT is nothing but it's a graphical representation which will indicate the variation of the base current with respect to the variation of the base emitter voltage. Okay, so that is the what we can say, the input characteristics of bipolar junction transistor. So you can just observe the equivalent circuit of BJT. So it is almost similar to that of, if you want to draw the characteristics of any of the circuits, then the circuit will be similar. So only thing is, so input circuit and output circuit, so only thing is we are replacing the switch. So in the previous video we have a MOSFET here, so here we are having a BJT here, that is the only difference. Okay, now this is a input loop and this is your output loop. Okay, so it is RB the base resistance, so base resistance, base current, collector resistance, collector current, so supply voltage and base voltage. Okay, this is a equivalent circuit of BJT. So here the graph between the base current and the base emitter voltage gives the input voltage, input characteristics. So here input characteristics is the graph which will between the base current and the base emitter voltage. So you can see here, so base current IB along the y axis and base emitter voltage along the x axis. So this is the graphical representation. So the base emitter voltage at which the BJT is conducting is called as the threshold voltage. That means, see here, this is the voltage at which initially there is a there is no current flow. So once the base emitter voltage which we are applying, base emitter voltage means this voltage which we are applying, which is sufficient, then your transistor starts conducting. So that point is called as a threshold voltage of your BJT. Okay, the point at which it is happened is called as a threshold point. The voltage at that particular point is called as a threshold voltage. Okay, so that is the characteristics. So initially there is no flow of current. Okay, once the your base emitter voltage is sufficient to drive this particular BJT, then the current starts increasing linearly. That point is called as threshold point, and the voltage at that particular point is called as a threshold voltage. Okay, so this is the variation of the base current, variation of base current with respect to the base emitter voltage. Okay, so that is the what we can say, the steady state characteristics or input characteristics of the bipolar junction transistor. Okay, once BJT starts conducting, the current across which becomes more, as I said, the current increases and the voltage becomes less. Okay, so that is the input characteristics. Now the output characteristics will indicate, it is a graphical representation for the indication of the variation of the collector current with respect to the collector emitter voltage. So here look at this, so in the y axis we have a collector current, so in y axis we have a collector to emitter voltage. Okay, so this is the graphical representation of the variation of the collector current for the variation of the collector emitter voltage. Okay, so that is called as output characteristics. So here so if you keep this constant and vary this, so it is a input characteristics. So if you keep this constant, vary this, then you can draw the output characteristics. That's it. So here also, so keeping the VB constant, VCE we are varying, so IC is also varies. So initially, so the characteristics of this is also similar to that of the MOSFET only. So initially the current rises linearly, then it saturates. So initially the if you vary the VCE, so current rises linearly, saturates. So this is for different base currents, so we have plotted the here. So for 5 base current values we have plotted the IC here. So this also, the operating regions are similar that of your MOSFET. So it is also operates in three regions. Okay, then what are those things? The output characteristics of BJT is operating in three, how your transistors does. So that is cutoff region, so cutoff region, saturation region, active region. So we'll see one by one what exactly happens in cutoff region. So now the cutoff region, so in this region the transistor is off, means the transistor is at the off state. So that is because the current IB is not enough or not sufficient to turn it on. That is why in the cutoff region the transistor is at the off state. So this is your cutoff region. So here the whatever the current which we are applying, it is not sufficient to turn on your BJT. That is why the transistor is at the off state. Okay, not enough to turn it on, so it's at the off state. So they are reverse bias. Next, active region. So in active region, transistor and act as an amplifier. Amplifier is nothing but which will amplifies the signal. So here the collector base junction is reverse biased and the base emitter junction is forward biased. Okay, so in this active region, this is a current saturation, this is called as active region. So this region, so in this active region, so it will be acting as an amplifier which will amplifies the signal. Okay, in saturation region what happens? So in saturation region the base current is what we can say, the significantly high base current is high, and the transistor is acting as a switch in that current saturation region. So here both see are forward bias. Here that is base to collector base junction and base emitter junction, both are forward biased, and then it is acting as a switch at that particular point. Okay, now this transfer characteristics we can indicate here the reasons of operation of the bipolar junction transistor. Look at this. So this is the voltage collector to emitter voltage, collector to emitter voltage, and this is the base current. Okay, so this is along y-axis and y-axis. So this particular region is a cutoff region. Okay, here active region, then it is saturation region. Okay, so the three regions of operations are indicated here. So here cutoff region, active region, and saturation region. So now we know that for the transistor, the emitter current is given by, so emitter current you can see here IE is equal to, so it is the current flowing through this emitter is a sum of the current from the collector and the base current. Okay, so this I am showing here. So look at this. So IB is equal to emitter current is equal to base current plus collector current. IB is equal to PE plus this one. Okay, now so the ratio of the collector current IC to the base current IB is known as a forward current gain. So the ratio of this IC divided by IB is called as beta F, that is called as a forward current gain. Similarly, the ratio of IC divided by IE, that is collector current divided by emitter current, is called as a forward reverse current gain. Yes, okay, so from this to the ratio we can calculate the IC. Here IC is equal to beta F into IB, so here also IC is equal to alpha F into IE. Okay, we get IC both cases. Okay, now dividing this equation number 1 divided by IC, that is IA by IC, IB by IC plus IC by IC. So you would divide the equation 1, divide the equation 1 divided by IC, you will get the IA by IC, IB by IC plus 1, that is IC by IC is equal to 1. So IC, IC will get cancelled. Now you will get 1 by alpha is equal to this one, this equation you will get after simplification. So call this as equation number 2. Okay, now the same two equation you solve for alpha F. So alpha F, if you are solving, so 1 by alpha F is equal to, so 1 by beta F plus beta. That means if you just simplify this equation and solve for alpha F, then you will get alpha F as beta F divided by 1 plus beta F. Now the same equation you solve for beta F. So this equation number 2 only. So if you just solve for beta F, so you will get beta F equation as beta F is equal to alpha F divided by 1 minus alpha F. Just the same equation number 2. Once you calculate alpha F using this, so next you calculate beta F using this. Okay, so alpha F and beta F you got now. Beta F you got. So from the figure, that means this equivalent circuit figure I'm talking about. So this, from this figure you can draw the KVL for the first loop. So KVL for the first loop and KVL for the second loop. So you just rewrite the equations there. So I am going forward here. Okay, so from the figure apply KVL to the input side first. So that is VB minus IBRB VBE. So if you are applying a KVL across the input, you will get this equation. So from this you calculate the IB, that is how much you will get the base current IB. So call the equation number 3 or 2, whatever it is, the consequent equation number you give. Then apply KVL for the output loop. So if you are applying KVL for the output loop, you will get this equation VCC plus ICRC minus VC is equal to 0. So if you simplify it, you will get VC this one. This is already done in your previous semester. Okay, next, but IB is equal to you from this simplifications. So from here, so IB is what? IB is equal to IC divided by beta. So here also IE is equal to this one. So from this you apply here now. So IC is equal to beta F into IB. Okay, so beta F, you keep it as it is. IB you calculated here, substitute this IB here. Okay, so after substituting that IB, substituting IC in equation number 4. So this you keep it aside. After this, next substitute IC, that is IC in equation number 4, and rewrite it. So you will get IC if you are substituting. So this equation you will get. So if you just take beta F, what exactly beta F? Okay, so you just take common terms outside and you just rewrite the equation, you will get the equation number 5. So that is VCE. So this call it as equation number 5. So the maximum collector current in the active region can be obtained by setting the collector base voltage 0. So when the collector to base voltage is 0 and base emitter voltage is equal to collector emitter voltage, then you can get the maximum collector current. So collector current IC max can be calculated as, so this equation VCC minus VCE divided by RC just by applying the KVL. So here VCC minus VCE is nothing but VBE here. So VCC minus VBE divided by RC. So by using these two equation, you can calculate the IC max also. Similarly, the IB max is, so IB is equal to IC divided by beta F. In the previous, in the first only we come across. So maximum base current is equal to maximum collector current divided by, that is gain. So when the transistor is in saturation region, so this is okay. Then when the transistor is in saturation region, so collector to emitter voltage is equal to collector to emitter saturation voltage. So in that case, collector saturation is IC charge is equal to VCC minus VCE. So the equation is already derived in the previous set. So VCC minus VCE saturation divided by RC. So using that, you can calculate the saturation value of the collector current. So similarly, saturation value of the base current is calculated as IC saturation divided by beta F. So these are the few of the calculations, few of the parameters which you are calculating in case of the bipolar junction transistor. So normally this circuit is designed so that the IB is higher than that of the beta. So that is called as a overdraft factor. So in some of the circuits, so which they are designed so that the base current is always greater than the base saturation current. So such is called, that condition is called as a overdrive factor. So overdrive factor can be calculated as, that is IB divided by IB saturation. So IB divided by IB saturation. So using that, you can calculate the overdrive factor. So it is the ratio of base current divided by base saturation current. So similarly, the forced beta or beta forced, which is calculated by using the other formula, forced beta. It is a force ratio, it's a ratio of saturation collector current to the base current. That is called as a forced beta or forced gain. Okay, so forced gain can be calculated as, so IC saturation divided by IB. So using that, you can calculate the forced beta. So total power loss in the junction, that is, so power input power divided by P is equal to VI, same. So total power loss in the junction can be calculated as PT is equal to, so this is the input power, this is the output power. So input power plus output power. So input power plus output power. So you will get the total power loss in the junction of the transistor. Okay. So PT is given by like this. So sum of input power plus output power. So using that, you can calculate the power loss of the transistor. Right. So what all things we discussed here. So here the BJT, operation of BJT we discussed, characteristics of the BJT, then transfer characteristics. So we have derived some of the expressions. So IC this one, then up dividing that equation by IC, you will get the alpha and beta values. So then applying KVL towards the input side, KVL apply on input side and across the output side if you apply. So calculate the IC and IB value, then VCE and VCE value we calculated, IC max, that is a collector maximum current of collector. So maximum current of base we calculated, then saturation current, everything we calculated, then overdrive factor, what exactly overdrive factor, it is a ratio of the base current divided by the base saturation current, that we calculated. Then we calculated the force gain, that is force beta, it is a ratio of the saturation collector current to that of the base current. So overdrive, force beta we calculated, then the total power loss in the junction, that means total power loss in the circuit. So the total power loss here, so total power loss is the power input power loss plus output power loss. So here, so P is equal to total power, P is equal to, so input power plus output power. So this input power is nothing but P is equal to VI. So V is VB into IB. So here VC into IC. So using that you calculated the total power loss in the circuit. So using this particular formula, look at this formula. So power loss equation VBE into IB. So VBE IB plus VC into IC, you will get the total power loss in the junction of the transistor. So this is about the switching characteristics of BJT. So other part, so the problems on this and the rest of the part we will take up in the next video. Thank you.